Once again, I greet each one of you in the most precious and holy name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Yes, this is a wonderful time to be in the presence of God. And this morning, as we continue to worship God, let us be in the worship mood and pay attention to God's word, that God will speak to our heart this morning. We are told that our earth has become a global village because of our modern technology. People can travel from one corner to another corner. I remember my childhood days. There was a man who traveled by aeroplane from our village. When he came to, he traveled from Dimapur to Bhubaneswar via Calcutta, and then from by bus to our village. He was narrating his story, how he traveled the first time, and all the villagers gathered together to listen his experience. And all the people, those who heard him, they said, "You are the fortunate man. You are the fortunate man in the village because you travel by aeroplane." But now, it is not important to travel by air, even by villagers. This morning, the Bible gives a very different picture of every human being. In the sight of God, every human being is significant. Whether you are rich or poor, you are short or tall, black or white, educated or uneducated, you are important to God. You are precious to God and you are valuable to God. The people of this world, they value people according to their social status, according to their educational qualification, and according to their riches and beauty. But today the text which we have read is Psalm 139. It tells us God is interested in us, and God is completely interested in us. What a joy to discover the truth that the God of the Bible is a true and only God. He is interested in me. He is interested in us. Psalm 139 is intensely a personal psalm, and it is called a crown of all psalms. We have here in the in Psalms we have 150 psalms. So in among all the psalms, this psalm is known as the crown of all psalms. These psalms also gives a pastoral ministry to those who feel that God has forsaken them. If you read the scripture, if you read these psalms, it gives you pastoral counseling. The God of the Bible is after you and after me. And God of the Bible, He loves you and He wants to bless you. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. The Lord is willing to bless us. And this morning, what I'm trying to do is, let us look to the scripture and let us meditate together. There are three main themes that is found in the Psalm 139, which I call three P's of God. This morning, let us, for our benefits, let us meditate together and ask the Holy Spirit of God to speak to us personally. Now, if you want to listen to your pastor, you may be disappointed. But if you pay attention to God's Spirit, yes, I believe the Lord is going to speak to you. The Lord has message to speak to you. So please turn to your Bible. Psalm 139. Let's read verse 1. Let's read together. It will be nice. Let's read together. O Lord, thou hast searched me and known me. The first verse it says, O Lord, thou hast searched me and known me. The first thought, the first theme, or the first topic which I would like to tell you is our God who perceives, who knows everything. Here the psalm is saying, O Lord, thou hast searched me and known me. In other translation it says, Lord, you have examined me. You have investigated me. You have explored me. And this examination is a very intimate examination. The Lord is examining his own people intimately. He knows our thoughts and our action. If you read verse 2, in verse 2 it says, Thou knowest my down seating and mine uprising. Thou understandest my thought afar up. He knows us in our conscious life, and also he knows us in our subconscious life. The subconscious life from which our thought comes. God knows our thought even before they come to the conscious mind. He knows our minds more closely than we know them. What a wonderful comfort. In the midst of all the failures and sins, God seeks the deep longing for holiness in our hearts. That's why when Peter was asked the third time, Do you love me? Jesus asked him. After the resurrection, Jesus asked Peter, Do you love me? The third time. And Peter said, Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you. In John chapter 21 verse 17. In 1 John chapter 3 verse 20 tells, Whenever our hearts condemn us, for God is greater than our hearts, He knows everything. He knows our positive life. He knows our negative life. He knows our passive life and He knows our active life. He knows our choice and our habits. In verse 3, it says, Thou compassest my path and my lying down and art acquainted with all my ways. In one of the translations it reads, You search out my path and my lying down and are acquainted with all my ways. The path represent the habits. And the ways represent the choice that we make. The activities of the day and the rest of the night are both known to God. The word search means is winnow or sifting. God sifts our habits. His knowledge is not only the knowledge of the facts, but also it is evaluation. God knows our choices, our habits. He knows our everything. A man who works on that stone, he was employed to erect a statue in a Greek temple. He was asked to make a huge statue, and this man worked, but he spent a lot of time. He spent much time of making the statue beautiful. Curving the backside of the statue. And one of the men said, Man, why you are spending much time working on the back side of the statue. No one will look at the back side. Everyone will look at the front side. And this man said, this is the way I work. People may not see the back side of that statue, but I believe God do. I believe God evaluate our values, our goals, and our priority. He knows our choices and our habits. He knows our inclination and our words. Even before a word is on my mouth, in my tongue, lo, O Lord, thou knowest it altogether. God knows the thought and the longing behind our words even before we pray. Sometimes we come to the church to pray. Even before we pray, before we utter the words, God knows our intention of our hearts this morning. He knows our past, present, and the future. If you read verse 5, it says, thou hast beset me behind and before, and laid thine hand upon me. Which says, thou hast beset me behind. He knows our past. Thou hast beset me before. He knows our future. And lays thy hand upon me. He knows our present. Our God, who knows everything. He perceives everything of our life. So this morning, let us rejoice in His presence. That our God, He knows very well. The second thought that ran through verse 7 to 12. Our God who pursues. The God who knows us is the God who cares for us. And He loves us so much that He will not let us go. Man always has the impulse of running away from God since the fall of man. Men try to hide from God. Run away from God. Whenever men sin in the Garden of Eden, the Adam and Eve they sin against God, when they ate the fruit, they tried to hide themselves from God. They tried to run away from God. That is the impulse man has. But in the hearts of men, you see two things. We long for God in one hand and try to run away from God from other hand. Sometimes we want to be very close to the Lord. In our spiritual life, we want to be very spiritual. We want to read the scripture more. We want to pray more. We want to witness more. But other times, we want to run away from God. That is there inside of man. Even if we lose our hold on Him, He does not lose His hold on us. Many times we may turn our back to Him, but He does not go away. He is with us. There is no escape from His pursuing love. He always pursues with us. He is always after us. You and I, we cannot hide anywhere in the world. Now people, they try to run away from God. We know a prophet of God. God sent him to Nineveh, but he ran away to Tarsus, Jonah. He thought, after buying the ticket, he went down and he was sleeping in the ship and thought, God is not mindful of me. God is knowing me where I am going. God has forgotten me. He has commanded me, yes, but now God is no more interested in me. I am going to Tarsus. But God knows everything. People sometimes they try to escape from God in the four different ways. That is what the psalmist is mentioning. If you read verse 8, it says, If I ascend up into heaven, thou art there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, thou art there. Ascending. If I ascend into heaven, thou art there. Men seek to climb up in the life to escape from God. There are certain things that attract us and is continuously, man is trying to continuously climb up to that level. It may be sometimes the success, the pleasure, sometimes the riches or human love. All of this may give some certain amount of fulfillment and happiness. For a certain time, period of time, it may give you some fulfillment or some satisfaction. And people take refuge in these things and they leave God out. It is often said among the influential, among the educated, among the rich people, piety is the crutch of the poor and the sick and the weak and the sorrowful. But healthy and happy man does not need God to support him. Piety is for the weak people, sick people, poor people. There was a rich family, a happy family, a son and a daughter. They had everything which money could buy except the knowledge of God and the fear of God. Very wonderful family, enjoying the riches, enjoying the life on this earth. When the children grew up, the son, he was addicted to different drugs. He could not make stable in his job. He was a slave of different addiction and he ruined his life. The daughter, the marriage of her, of the daughter of, was collapsed. He was not stick to God's principle. She led an immoral life and people were talking around the community, people are talking about that girl. And these parents, those who thought that they do not need God, now they received a heartache, a ingratitude from their children, but in the midst of their own happiness, in the midst of their discouragement, God was pursuing them in the love. My friends, if you are going through a difficult time, if you are going through a tough situation in your life, remember, God has not left you. God is after you. God is willing to find you. You cannot hide yourself from the omniscient, omnipotent, and omnipresent God. You cannot hide yourself. And some people, they try to hide from God or escape from God by descending. That's what verse 8 says. If I ascend up to heaven, thou art there. If I make my bed, or if I descend, by descending. If I make my bed in Sheol, thou art there. Some people, they deliberately descend into the ways of hell to escape from God. They sell their soul to the devil and they call the devil to come and live in their hearts. They make their body as the devil's temple. They think that God will not pursue them. They sink deep into the irreligion and immorality. They think that they are out of God's loving reach. God cannot reach them. My friend, wherever you are, whatever your condition may be, the holy God, the loving God is after you. And some people, they try to escape from God by taking the wings of morning. That is in verse 9. If I take wings of morning, it means traveling at the speed of light and trying to escape from God in human efforts and achievements. They want to travel, they want to make a good achievement. There are some people who take refuge in their work. Sunday also, in some company, is a working day. Even for our children, the Satan has planned such a way that our children, they will not able to come to Sunday school. Every Sunday there will be tuition. Every Sunday there will be some examination. Every Sunday there will be some interview. So our children goes to such examination and interview. They are not able to come to Sunday school to learn God's word. These people, by taking the wings of morning, the work and the accomplishment to get away from God. No time for God. They want to escape from God. They don't want to come to the church. They don't want to read the God's word. But God is after you. You cannot hide from God's presence. God is after you. And some people, they hide in darkness. That is in verse 11 to 12. Verse 11 to 12. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there shall thy hand lead me, and thy right hand shall hold me. If I say, surely the darkness shall cover me, even the night shall be light about me. Yea, the darkness hideth not from thee, but the light shineth as the day. The darkness and the light are both alike to thee. Hiding in the darkness. It could mean the darkness of death. There are some people who try to escape from God by taking their own life. They don't want to come to God for a solution. They want to finish their life. They want to destroy their life. One day a girl called her pastor over telephone and said, "Pastor, I have failed in my life. I have failed in my love affair. The boy whom I love, he cheated me. And now I have no meaning to live on this earth. And I'm going to commit suicide. But I have made a plan. It looks like as an accident, so no one will suffer. But only one thing is holding me back, and I want to ask that. Please give me a frank answer, a honest answer I'd like to listen from you. Suppose if I die, will I have to face God after my death?" The pastor said, "Certainly, we all have to face even after our death. By death, you cannot hide or you cannot escape from God. Because at the end of your life, the death is not the end of your life. One day, we all are going to face the judgment seat of Christ. And therefore, there are people, those who are trying to escape from God by ascending, by descending, by taking wings of the morning, and by hiding in darkness. God who perceive, God who knows, God who pursue, and God who purifies. And this morning, if you look at verse 19 to 24, Psalm 139, verse 19 to 24, God purifies. Let us look at this verse briefly. The third point God purifies. Our God is a God of purity. One of the beauty of our God is He loves holiness. The outward purity, also the inward purity. This psalm is suddenly aware of the evil around him in verse 19 to 20. These evil men, they exalt themselves against God's authority. The psalmist wanted his environment to be purified. Purity of life, the outward purity of life, also important to God. At the same time, the inward purity, verse 23 to 24. Psalmist also discovered the evil inside in his heart. The evil inside of his heart. He says, "Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my thoughts. And see if there be any wicked ways in me, and lead me in the way of everlasting." Psalm is saying, "Lord, in my own eyes, I found that I'm a very righteous person. I'm a holy man. In my own eyes, I'm a very honest man. I'm a very pious man. But Lord, this morning, this is my prayer." The psalm is praying, "Lord, you search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my thoughts. And if there be any wicked ways in me, lead me in the way of everlasting." My friend, what is your prayer today, this morning? Do you have any prayer in your heart this morning? Yes, we have so many prayer. And we have interest in the intercessory prayer. We have prayed a lot. There was a long list. Our deacons, Reverend Bijoy Kumar Das, he prayed. And we all said, "Amen. Yes, God is going to answer." But what is your prayer today? This morning, do you have prayer in your heart? What kind of prayer we are going to offer in the presence of God? God knows. He knows your thoughts. He knows your actions. He knows your situation. He knows your problems. He knows your past, your present. Also, He knows your future. He knows everything about you. And nothing is hidden from Him. And God is, after knowing all these things, your past, present and future, He is after you. He is interested in you. You cannot escape from Him. Because you have come to His presence, you cannot escape from Him. He loves you. And He wants to forgive you. He wants to cleanse your life. He wants to make His own. And He wants to use you for His kingdom. This morning, will you pray like the psalmist? Will you say, "Lord, search me. Oh Lord, search me and know my heart. Try me and know my thoughts. And see if there be any wicked ways in me, and lead me in the way of everlasting." Before we close, shall we all stand, and may I request the choir to lead us a special number. We shall "At the Cross." Let us sing with them, and let us rededicate our life and commit our ways to the Lord. And let us examine our hearts this morning, and let us pray like the psalmist. "Oh Lord, search my heart, try my heart, and know my thoughts, and lead me in the way of everlasting."